Every single homeowner should have these three items. The first one, if you followed along here on Budget Lawns for any length of time, you know that I don't really like to buy into all the bells and whistles, and I don't take all the free product that all the companies are shilling out to get the free videos off of, but I held off for this one as long as I could. But this past summer, if you remember when I did the huge project in my back lawn where I tore out a lot of sod, replaced it with mulch, put in a little rock feature, improved some grade in some areas and smoothed some things out, I could not have done that as easily as I did without investing in a Gorilla cart. My gosh, what a time saver, a backbreaker, a deal breaker, whatever you want to call it. The Gorilla cart is absolutely worth the investment if you are going to be doing anything physically around your house. I think that's the 4 cubic feet one. It was around $109 at Lowe's. Wasn't hard to put together at all, and I got to stop using the pickle buckets to transport materials, whether it be mulch or topsoil or sand or whatever it was around my lawn. Stopped using the pickle bucket, saved me a lot of trips and a lot of time going with the Gorilla cart. Now, you know, at the last house I used the pickle buckets because I had a really small lawn and I wasn't going far. But if you've got to transport the materials any length of distance at all, uphills, slopes, whatever it may be, the Gorilla cart is worth the money tenfold, I'm telling you. And not only that, hey, look, we got a swimming pool in our neighborhood. It's not just good for lawn work, but it's also a good transport gadget for, I don't know, inflatables and towels and lunches for picnics and stuff to go to the pool. So twice the bang for your buck on a Gorilla cart. Highly recommend. And guess what I'm recommending? No link below. Just go get yourself one. They make them in bigger sizes, wheelbarrows, Gorilla cart, two thumbs up. All right, here's another one that I think every single homeowner should have. It's a sprinkler. Am I saying you should have this sprinkler? No. Do I think these sprinklers are super, super awesome? Yes. Okay. Look, there are a lot of reasons a homeowner should have a sprinkler. One of the best reasons is your kids, if you got kids, love to play in them. Look, I played in a sprinkler as a kid. We put these things under the trampoline. I mean, what more fun can you have in the summertime than jumping in and out of a sprinkler? So if you don't have a lawn or a garden or anything to take care of, but you're a homeowner and you've got kids, get a sprinkler for that sake. I mean, they're just fun. But look, I've tried several different sprinklers in the past. I've done the pulsating ones. What do you call those? Is that the right thing? You know what I'm talking about, those kinds. And they're all right. And I've tried one similar to this, and it was good too, just a different brand. But I found these this past summer, and I really like this one in particular for several reasons. One, it's metal. Two, it is so adjustable. And when I mean adjustable, I mean in more, we got cobwebs all over it. I hadn't used these in a long time. We didn't have to that much. Well, I just didn't late in the season because I kind of ran out of steam. But anyway, back to the point at hand. When I say adjustable, I mean in far more ways than one. Look, you can adjust this thing here, plus and minus. That will, water. That will control how far out it will shoot with this plus and minus feature here. This thing right here will control how far down and back it goes in that oscillating direction. And then you can shut off different holes across the top here that will close them off here on the ends and provide more pressure and coverage here within the middle part of the sprinkler. So look, 1, 2, 3 ways to adjust it. That is super, super cool. I really like how easy it is to attach it to the end of the hose. And then the other sprinkler I had a lot like this one, I had to use a toothpick for what I'm about to show you. And in this one, this is what I liked about it. To keep these little holes cleaned out, I didn't have to use a toothpick. It came with this handy little thing here on the end that you take out, and you can just, I don't know, stick it in there and clean out the holes when you need to. So that's super, super, super handy. stick this end on the faucet when you're done using it. Let the water run through it, run out. Keeps it nice and clean. A lot of the debris out of it. Just look, a handy little sprinkler to have for the kids to play in and to water your lawn if you do that. I got two of these because if you know the nature of my back lawn, it's kind of more slender and shotgun style. So I can put one on each end, get all the coverage I need, pull them both together after my times on each section run out. And it doesn't take me long at all to water the back lawn for half an inch to an inch with two sprinklers. I cut my time in, I would say half, just by getting two of them. Kind of makes sense, right? Two sprinklers half the time. Anyway, so that's number two, get you a good sprinkler. And number three, every single homeowner should have one of these. And I don't care what brand it is. I've used the one I've got and I've used the one that my brother has. They both work the same. If you figured it out here, I'm not a gadget guy. I'm not going to do a ton of research to find out what the best of everything is. I'm just going to get something and use it and I'll make the best of any situation. But I think every homeowner should have, and this is non-lawn related, but every homeowner should have an air fryer. I am not kidding y'all. There's not been one person I met that didn't agree with me that the air fryer is a game changer. And here's another cool thing. I've got one of the Blackstone flat top grills in my backyard on the back patio. They're starting to make those suckers now with three air fryer baskets in them. Like, I'm surely going to get one of those one day, but I've got a Blackstone that works just fine. It's one of the original models. They've come a long way since then. But I'm telling you, if you don't have an air fryer yet, it makes cooking some of your favorite foods a breeze. For me in particular, I love, I mean love, bone-in chicken wings. I'm not talking boneless. Boneless wings aren't. Wings are just chunks of meat that they've added wings onto to satisfy the people who are scared of the bones. Like, look, the bone-in wings are made so easy in an air fryer. I like to put them in the oven before I'd grill them. But getting out oil and heating that up and splattering it all over the kitchen is just a pain in the neck. But you can get that same crisp and that same texture and that same product out of an air fryer with a bone-in chicken wing. Not to mention, throw some chicken thighs in there, some chicken breasts, season those things right. I mean, it's like having fried chicken. None of the oil, none of the mess, none of the... Look, it's healthier to a certain extent. But if you don't have an air fryer yet, you gotta get you one of those. Christmas time is coming up, and guess what? All three of these products, whether it be the Gorilla Cart, this Eden oscillating sprinkler, or an air fryer, whatever brand you want, look, if you don't know what you want to get from that significant other this Christmas, I would go with one of those. And no, I don't have links for you below. Look, go do a little research. Find what you want. All right, here we go. That's it for this edition of Budget Lawns, my friends. I appreciate you being here as always. I hope you'll stick around with me throughout the off season. Just because the lawn season is over doesn't mean the content is over as well. Look, we all came together in the beginning over our love of lawn care and just the enjoyment that grass and taking care of something can bring us. But I think there's a lot more that we would connect with besides just our lawns. So just because I'm not putting out a video about the cultural practices that we've heard over and over and over again doesn't mean we can't come together about more interesting, valuable content on a weekly basis. So I hope you'll join me. But until next time, take care.